has been the best start since I joined the league ever in CSUP for me. And I don't say this to clickbait or something, it's actually true. I've never been so excited to join a league race. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Pear. I'm a content creator, coach in spare time, and CSUP competitive racer. The combos of this first week were the Osprey on Tilksport Rallycross and the Osprey on Faenza. Trust me, I was as skeptic as you when I first heard this. Usually I start around by practicing the combinations, by just doing some laps to see how consistent I can be, what my fastest lap times are. But this time was different. I needed to get the consistency and fast lap times in, or else I would not be able to follow the pack. So off I went, all the way to Tilksport to drive an old GP car on dirt. My training went great and soon I was putting in some very consistent laps of about 27.150 seconds. My best training lap was a 27.055. Remember that number. I was hitting apexes left and right, stayed on the same racing line for miles. As for Faenza, training was the same, with laps of about 28.0 or lower, topping my training session off with a 27.8-ish. Suddenly it was race day. I was super nervous heading into the first qualifier session and without any confidence of getting into the top 3, but surely I was starting to put in some consistent lap times and found me battling with Nico Minardi and my teammate Warrell for the top 3 during this qualifier. While our times were quite similar, I think my consistency training really helped on this track. While getting near the end, Warrell got an amazing lap of a 27.1, and I was thinking that he won this one, because 21.1s are very, very good laps. But currently we're sitting on a 1-2, which is amazing. Then some magical things happened. First, I hit the banger lap of 27.069, which was very close to my personal best. A couple of minutes later, Warrell did a 27.057, which is like 2/1000ths of my PB, and I was thinking, yeah, that's it, I'm done, I'm P2, which is great of course. But then things got really tight in the end. I did a 27.03 during my third last lap in a very stressy situation, and which is a personal best for me. I was super glad with this, as you can see on my face during the live stream. I was super happy. But this was only one qualifier now, so it was time for the real test, the race. You see, ITGL is a ghost race, so which means no POV issues, no damage, no incidents probably, and most important of all, no slipstream. This showed early, as I was keeping my lead early on. In lap 1, Warrell hits the barrier, pushing him down all the way to the back of the pack, with damage. A couple of laps later, Minardi does the same thing. So for both of them, it was now a race against themselves. Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity, to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment, that you capture, just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already, mom's spaghetti. He's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes rabbit, he choke, he's so mad, but he won't give up. He won't have it, he knows his whole back to these ropes. It don't matter, he's dope, he knows that, but he's broke. He's so stagnant, he knows when he goes back to this mobile home. That's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old rhapsody better go capture this moment and hope it don't do that. Lose his mouth in the music, the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime, you better lose his mouth in the music, the moment. The race went very smooth and I managed to grab my first win during ITGL. My teammate managed to climb up back to P2 and Minardi, he was back in top 4 as well. So they managed to do a great job recovering. Let's go! During my live stream you can see how happy I am, but I'm instantly focused again, since the race is not over yet. There is still a second round. The moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one.
While starting from the back is not beneficial, I managed to climb my way up. No mistakes, no penalties, no damage, pure pace and determination to win and prove that I'm still a superstar. Okay, sorry, that was so cheesy, but point still stands though. Winning the second race in Faenza as well, I felt so euphoric, and I think it was a great way to start off the season. Now I'm leading with a 12-point difference to my teammate Warl, and we are leading the team's championship with 32-point difference towards Minardi Simsworth, which is a great start for us. Honestly, I'm excited to see how this league turns out. If you are as well, make sure to subscribe and also go watch my other league race videos if you want to get better, starting by this one up here. I'll see you guys on track. Bye.